Hey everyone, Matt Covert here again from howtobecomearacecardriver.com, and in this video we're going to talk about yaw angle. And if you haven't seen the slip angle video, highly recommend that you go and watch that first, because this is a similar concept, and I'll throw a link to that right up here on the screen somewhere so you can go and check that out. And the rest of us are going to hop right on in. So yaw angle can do a couple things for you. It can help you find a balance to your vehicle. It's something that you'll have to feel out, and that comes with experience, obviously. But it'll help you find your optimum slip angles. See why I wanted to have you watch the other video first? Yeah, exactly. So let's talk about what yaw angle is. Okay, and like I said, it's pretty similar to something we've already talked about. It is the difference between where something is pointed and where it's actually going. And the difference between them is, in this case, going to be the yaw angle. And I think I made that same little diagram in the slip angle video, because it's the same basic concept. So let's go ahead and draw the chassis of a vehicle. And I know I use the same shape for tires as well, but I'll just make four little marks here to designate this as a vehicle. Okay, let's draw a center line that goes down through this vehicle chassis, okay? This is the center line that shows where the vehicle is actually pointed, all right? Regardless of where the front tires are pointed, etc., okay? And now we're going to draw another vector, I think is the right word, that shows the actual direction of travel. So even though this vehicle is pointed in one direction, it's actually going this way, all right? And the difference between these two directions is the yaw angle, okay? Not a difficult concept to understand, but once you understand it, you'll really be able to have a better grip.